T-shirt with a rainbow lorikeet on it in that clip.
You can borrow it. Yeah, I was just saying, you can borrow it, yeah. Isn't it a ripper? It's actually my best friend's T-shirt.
Really? Love it. You borrowed it.
It's super comfy that look awesome.
It's truly worn in. There's a few holes in the armpit, but we won't focus on that.
No, well, we came in on your latest single, Oh My Goddess, and what does it mean to you to be a goddess? Like, how do you own a goddess?
Oh, that's a good question. Well, it's, you know, look, I'm a bit partial to the old journey, the self-help, the talk. I like to go inwards, to go outwards, to share. I think it's lots of artists do that when they want to create something meaningful. And this whole last record for me was incredibly meaningful. And Oh My Goddess was kind of the last track, which was meant to be a bit of a booster thrust to that sort of personal journey that I'd been on throughout the record. And it's hard to explain, it's hard to put into words. I liken it to busting out of the chrysalis as a butterfly, but acknowledging the goo. That there has to sometimes be some mud.
Goo.
There's always goo.
Always
look,
goo.
In a life well lived, there's always goo. Yeah, don't you think?
I'd wear that T-shirt.
That's the next T-shirt. Yeah.
Okay, we're going to go into business.
I also saw that there's like a sneaky bonus track on this single.
Yes.
Do you feel like we should bring back the bonus track?
Absolutely. I grew up loving B-sides and liner notes and bonus tracks and collaborations. Sometimes you don't get that so much with Spotify and streaming services, which are amazing. I mean, you know, they're like crack. I love my Spotify. I can't get off it. But you sometimes miss out on B-sides and old-fashioned things when you used to buy a single. Those were often my favourite tracks. So
just
I thought
covering something.
Yeah, and something a little bit different from the artist. So mine is a duet with my friend Van Walker. It's actually a cover of one of his songs, and we sing it together and we reinterpret it for the Oh My Goddess single, and it just feels so nice. It's a bit of a harking back to the 90s and the early 2000s when I was all about the B-side.
Yeah. Well, it's a hard thing to find nowadays. So how do you put that into, like, because what it used to be, it'd be like you'd finish an album and if you left it on, there'd be a little something at the end. But I don't know, I wouldn't even know how you do that.
I don't even know. I have people to do that because
I need people. I said
on
I need
the
people.
Internet. How it gets on the internet is a mystery to me.
Hidden tracks, I just give lorikeet them T-shirt.
Yeah. I really don't know, but I'm glad it's there.
Ella, you're heading out on a 10-date tour next month. As a rocker-turned country star, like, how different are the crowds? Like, is there still a mosh pit?
Oh, gosh, thank you so much. Like, I feel like I'm absolutely still earning my stripes in country and in alt country, but it has been an incredibly warm reception, changing genres and expanding that way. And I just call it twang. You know, I've always loved music. I've always loved music with twang. I was raised on it. I think it's pretty authentic to me coming from the country. Mm. Yes, I have actually caught many trains and sat on many fences and dug many holes. So it's not too much of a stretch to go into that world. But, yeah, I am noticing that in the crowd, you've got some old Killing Heidi fans, you've got some Ella Hooper solo fans who might have come on board with me when I was doing more sort of, you know, like, you know, depressing folk ingenue kind of phase of my solo career. And now I've added alt country Americana into that. Yeah. It's kind of an unholy mix, but it's working. Yeah. They're coming, it's working.
Yeah. And it's working.
And speaking of twang, a lot of places where you can hear some twang chants would be at the footy. And this is actually a welfare check for you because this was you last night. You're a Demons fan.
Oh my
they
God.
Were up against Hollywood.
No!
You were drowning your sorrows. Are you okay?
You cheeky buggers.
How's the cheese board?
Yeah. The cheese board was incredible. Jesse makes such a good cheese board because, Rove, you know us from our...
Oh, yeah.
You know us from our rock and roll days.
Oh, yeah.
We've grown up. We've swapped some expensive things for expensive cheese.
Yes.
Oh,
and we just enjoy that in moderation these days.
Now, last time you were on the show, you hadn't got your L's yet. It's been a bit of time. Have you got your driver's license yet?
Yeah.
Did you drive yourself in here? Did you reverse parallel park?
I'm going to have a word to your researcher.
Yes.
No, I still don't have my license. because my partner got his.
Yes.
Oh,
and that was kind of the I was doing lessons, lots of lessons in the country. I've also just moved house, so life is chaos. Hey.
Personal Uber driver.
Yeah, that's what excuses, Ella. That's what I'm hearing.
I've got excuses.
You can find out more about Ella's tour on our website. Please thank Ella Hooper.